जन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरस्य गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातर्याजुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतरिवं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञानादि तं नयमाम शरणं।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माई हार्ट टचिंग मिलियंस ऑफ दंडवत प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माई परम आराध्य ओम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद्भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज एंड सेम मिलियंस ऑफ दंडवत प्रणाम And to the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Shila, Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. Yesterday this subject was so high, I know. But precious, it is essential to know all these things. If anyone not knowing all the Siddhants, he cannot be strong. At any time he may fall down. So especially for preachers, they should know all these things. Siddhanta boliya chitte na karo avishwas. Only you should not try to jump on the top. Manjari bhav. This is our aim and object. But we should try to go from beginning. And that is why I am taking you in very easy path. Though subject was very high, deep, but now crumbs, gradually it will come some easiest, and then very rasagya it will come. Very rasagya. So you should not be disheartened at all. So high subject and we are not touching even by mind. So don't be hopeless. Where he is? Oh, he can come here and give a seat here, chair. Where he is? Oh, come on. Are you come on here. Come on, phone.
You can take
a chair. Okay. We got a chair in the basket. I heard that you are coming. If no seat, then anyone can hear? Oh, you should sit here. Give a chair and Prabhu, Chidandi Maharaj, you can come here. Chidandi Maharaj, you can come.
All right.
How are you?
All right.
Okay? You can come here, yes?
They're eating a lot of prasadam, they're getting...
Yes, yes. You know perhaps that at the time of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Prabhupada, he served him so much. At that time, he was quite young, golden collar, very attractive.
Still some.
So, he served so much in
France.
Vrindavan, perhaps.
France.
That everywhere.
Everywhere. So I like him. Now we should come in our Harikatha. Yesterday I explained first a slok. And now, about Jiva Tattva. Bhayam dvitiyad avinivishatasyat. Ishat apitasya viparjyo smriti tanmayato. Buddha avajet tang bhaktai kajesham guru deva tatma. Really, this slok has been uttered by Sukadeva Goswami for Parikshit Maharaj. He questioned and he answered. I think all the literatures, Vaishnava literature, one is questioning and other is replying. Like a dialogue, like Rai Ramananda Sambhad, Sanatana Sambhad, and other Sambhad. He questioned, a jeev who is by transcendental
constitution,
he is chit, and maya is jada prakriti. How he was entangled. Very wonderful. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur, in his garland of Srimad Bhagavatam, he has quoted this sloka. Bhayam dvitiyad avinivishata. Krishna is one. He is our worshipable or anything. Without second. But, as I told you, he has so many powers,
potencies,
and from so many jivas, so many worlds like these, Nanda, Yashoda and all there. But Krishna is the root. Jiva, by constitution, Jivere Swarupaya Nitya Krishna Das. Nitya Krishna Das is always happy. But Dityad Avinimeshataha, he looked upon Maya. And at once he was influenced. When he was influenced, Maya took him and
throw him.
He came so far away, and then she covered his jiva tattva by two bodies, gross and subtle. Why he looked towards Maya? He should have looked upon Krishna But Krishna has given independence. If you misuse your independence, you will be punished. No one can save. You have independence to serve Guru. Also, you are independent to choose a qualified, sincere Guru. You did. Or later on, you are independent also to insult him, give up him, not following his orders. But surely you must know that you must be punished. Anyone cannot say. If you are doing any aparadh to Guru, what Guru will do? What? He is very merciful.
He lament for.
But Krishna is not so. Guru may forgive. It may be. But Krishna will what?
Crush him.
Crush him in pieces. You know, as blade of grass. And you serve him like Krishna. If you are serving a blade of grass, that he is my worshipable Krishna. Will he have any fruit or not?
Yes. Sure.
Huh?
Yes.
Will he have not?
He will.
Grass will give him. Or who will give?
Krishna.
Krishna.
But he is serving grass.
Avidhi Purvakam.
See, that fruit comes from Krishna. But he is worshipping blade of grass. So you should know, if your guru is not so high standard, so not siddha, but he is sincere. But he must be in Madhyam Adhikar, Madhyam or Uttam, best Uttam. He must be. Knowing all Shastra and also by Shastra Praman and by his Yukti,
by logic and evidence,
he can remove all your doubts. If he cannot do, he is not Guru. So, if you are doing something wrong in his lotus feet, then he may be merciful, but Krishna will punish you. So we should be very careful for this. And that is why he is telling. Ishat petasya viparjaya smriti. He is standing on the middle line of that
Maya, one side Maya, another side Chit-Jagat.
Chit-Jagat and Achit-Jagat. And by chance, he saw the very lovely this Maya. Oh, they are enjoying very beautiful ladies, husbands, children's mama, mummy, like this. Oh, very beautiful. I should. And attracted me. Came and at once Maya was guarding there. But Jivas were not seeing him and took him and throw in this world and settle and cross bodies. Yes. At once, what became? Oh, in this body, which is a bag of his stool, urine,
blood,
so many.
Pus.
Oh, that I am this body. And what became? Mai, mera.
Me and my.
Me and mine. He tangled. And this is Ninanbe ka pher. What Ninanbe ka pher?
Never satisfying tendency.
If you will enter, no way to come out. Forever you will. No way.
No escape.
Way, but you cannot find yourself. So, ishat api tasya viparjyo smriti. When you looked upon Maya and you left Krishna by your free will, independence, then viparjyo smriti, dehatma abhiman came. Dehatma abhiman?
Bodily conception of life.
Bodily conception comes.
Dehatma abhiman came. Viparjyo smriti, I am nitya das of Krishna. I can serve Krishna with love and affection as anyone in Braja also, in Vaikuntha also, like gopis. I can serve. But shadow of this here, we began to love beautiful or form of Maya Jagat. After long time, any person, Bhagavat in his
armpit,
tilak, mundit mastakam, tilak, he came, what you are doing my brother, my sisters? Well, misguided, derailed by that path. Come with me. I will show you path. How can you be happy? So, tan maya to buddha abhajet tang bhaktai kajeshang guru devatatma. And then, he tells, be in sadhu sangha. Sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sarva shastra. Law matra sadhu sangha sarva siddhi hai. Even they can change you in a moment. They can change. And you can be happy. Jayatma,
samprasiddhi.
If anyone doing chanting, remembering really, and he is not happy, I cannot believe. Cannot believe. If anyone chanting sincerely, he may be Kanishtha Adhikari no harm, but he is really chanting, waving for Krishna. He may be entangled in so many anarths, like Ajamil and others.
Billo Mangal.
Very lusty, you know, so many, thousand and lakhs. Then, they will show you path. They will advise. I know a guru. By his help, I'm very happy. So, come along me. I will show you guru. He is like Path Pradarshak Guru. And in the meantime, Krishna became merciful. He became Chaitya Guru. Oh, you should follow this. Then both together went to a real guru. He accepted him. And then he began to do bhajan. Gradually anarth going. So, bhaktai ka jeshang guru devatatma. So he accepted Guru. Guru showed him that path. And then he began to do bhajan of that Krishna. ekasyaiva mamansasya jivasyaiva mahamate baddho asya abhidyamano api abhidya cha tathetara. Krishna is telling to Uddhava in Ekadasya Skanda. Aim and object is written in 10th canto, especially. Gyan Vairagya Siksha, especially Vairagya, from 1 to 9. And then 10th canto is process. So, in this, Abhidheya Tattva, Sadhan Tattva, he has taken all the examples from Ekadasya Skandha. Bhagavan told to Uddhava. When he told? When all the dynasty of Yadavas quarreling among them, and they went to Golok Vaikuntha Dham in any way, and Krishna was sitting under a tree, peepal tree, keeping his feet on this feet like this, and one down, and he was thinking something. In the meantime, a bear,
hunter.
He thought that any mriga, his tongue is there, and he shoot it. Before this only,
before this.
Uddhav came there, Krishna wanted to go, and that time Krishna mercifully told him, from 6 to 29 chapters, only the process. In this, this is this. Uddhav, he Mahamati, very much intelligent, very much. Who is intelligent actually? Krishna Bhakt. If any sincere Krishna Bhakt, he is intelligent. Because he had chosen the path of bhakti. This is the reality. And it may be so many intelligent person in world. Oh, in Yuktarashtra, the president of America, Russia and others, they think we are most intelligent. But not really. A bhakti is intelligent. Uddhav, you should know that in this world or any world, Jeev is my part and parcel, soul. Anadi Vidya. When Jeev was taken to this world, Anadi Kal.
Time being unlimited.
So, Anadi Avidya. By Anadi Kal, by Anadi Avidya. No Adi.
No origin.
So Anadi Avidya, by Anadi Avidya, they have been Baddha, conditioned soul. And Anadi Vidya, Yogmaya, they will be liberated from this world. Here he is telling that what is the meaning of Ansa, part. Part means like any flower, oh, this is part. Then this whole is not whole.
Some less.
Now?
More or less.
And now?
Nothing.
Finish. In world, this world like this. But they are not. The part and parcel of Krishna, not Krishna as it is. Krishna is it. But part and parcel comes. Mama Ivanso, Jiva Loke, Jivuta Sanatan, everywhere it has been written. So he is telling, we should know how answer, how depart. Krishna is whole. He cannot be divided into parts. Never. Because no side, no up, down. His many part, his in him, whole world cannot be part. So, like stone and like wood, we cannot cut him. And Jiva is not part like this. It is like one lamp, Indian lamp, you know, not bulb. Indian lamp.
Ghee lamp. Ghee lamp.
Ghee lamp. And it was burning. It was giving light. And from one light, hundreds of pradeep were lighted. Or, so this is like somewhat example, not fully. So, main lamp
original
is giving light. Other lamps also giving light. There are some lamps which are equal to that, and some very small, according to small and bigger, they are giving light. But this lakshan,
symptom,
is not accurate. There is nothing in the world that we can give quite example. Never. Another example. We have not seen Chintamani, but you should suppose there is Chintamani. What is the meaning Chintamani? A
desire stone.
Money means?
Jewel.
It can give anything you like. So much gold, so much coin, so much this, that, every season. But you should also know that what will come out of that Chintamani, it will not be Chintamani. Not Chintamani. She will give gold as much as you want. But gold is not himself Chintamani. So all coming, but not like Krishna. So, Chintamani is giving gold, but Chintamani is there without any
transformation
or peace. In same way, Krishna is there. And that part and parcel, like two, Swansa and Bibhinams. Here we are telling about Bibhinams. So he are telling that one name, Swans, all qualities in Krishna, all are in Swans, avatar, like Ram, Nishingha and others. But not all rush. Tattvatah they are one. But by rash vichar, Krishna is avatari and all are avatar. And Bibhinans. So he is telling about swans, one lamp to another lamp. both are equal. Both are giving equal prakash. In what Shakti is there? Oh, all that Shakti, the Shakti of Prakash is in another lamps. So if you will take a light from one lamp and you should delight and keep it, but that Pradeep will be what? Same as it was, no less. Similarly, any so much swans has been taken, Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnat, Uchyate, Purnasya, Purnameva. Like so. Swans lakshan Purushavatar, Leelavatar, Ram in others. Purushavatar, first, second, third Vishnu. Bibinans, Chintamani haite, Khudraswarna. For example of Chintamani, Chintamani is same, and so much gold is coming. But gold has not that quality that Krishna has.
That's the Bibinans.
Anu, some Anu, something is there. If they are with Chintamani, no Bikar, but they will come out of Chintamani, they will be Vikrita. Vikrita means they will be transformed. So, jeev is bibhinams. Ekaha, shuddha, swayang jyotir, nirguno, gunashraya, sarva, sarvagva, anabrita sakshi, niratma, atma, man, para. These are the qualities of?
Jivas.
Vastu, parabrahma. But there is some difference. The difference he is telling. Some say, we are all God. No? And they give example, tattvam asi, sarvam khalu idam brahma, prajnanam brahma, and one more.
Aham brahmasmi.
Aham brahmasmi. But he is telling, why in Shruti it has been told? You should know that Shankaracharya was very tricky. He has come to fulfill the desire of Krishna. Krishna told him, and go and hide me. Why? Because all asur are serving me, doing archan pujan, and they want to be himself very strong, like Hiranyakashipu, like Ravan. So you should go and tell them, why you are so worshipping Krishna? Oh, you are himself Brahma. Sarvam khalu idam Brahma. We are all Brahma. So you should know that we are not Brahma. We are part and parcel and Nityadas. Krishna is one without second. But jeev, unlimited. Here in Vaikunth in Golok Vrindavan. This is different. So he will tell the differences. Jeev anek anek Sri Kanta. All unlimited jivas. Can you say that in this jeev is there or not?
No.
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 Jeev is here or not?
No.
But Paramatma is here or not?
Yes. Yes.
Paramatma is there. Without Paramatma, any Shakta cannot be.
No existence.
So, in this, Jivatma is there. Paramatma is also there. One taking the fruitive karmas and other
witness
only. He does not eat anything. So he does not, he is not conditioned, but jivas or fruitive karma. Or nitya suddha, Supreme Lord, Parabrahma. Nitya Shuddha. Shuddha means?
Eternally pure.
How pure? No Maya there. Very far away. There is Yoga Maya. She is Vishuddha. So, Maya cannot attract him, but Jeev. Very minute. At any time, she can attract. Krishna always nirmal, jyoti, prakash. Prakash means light. And jiva, sarubhram, by sarubhram, he can be malin.
Contaminated by mistaken identity.
Yes. Tini nirgun. Nirgun. What is the meaning of nirgun? Nirgun? Yes.
Nirgun without any, not any material qualities, not influenced by the modes of
life. No. You nirgun?
Nirgun means that he is free from the influence of the three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas. He is above, transcendental.
More?
Tribhir guna maya bhava ebhi sarvam idam jagat. Krishna said in Gita, I am always above the modes and this world is below the modes.
Nirgun means?
Turiya tattva.
Not my gun, but all
aprakit
guna are there. Sagun, what means?
With quality.
All aprakis gun. So nirgun and sagun both are same. Krishna is nirgun and sagun both. But jivas can come in this stage. Krishna is aprakit gunasya. All transcendental qualities are Krishna. Very beautiful. You should know that Krishna is here, but in form of Paramatma, Chaturbhuj, very small. But those who are doing bhajan of Krishna, actually, like Pigalo Mangal and others, oh, Krishna himself is there, like Brajendranandan. Those who are serving Vaikuntha, Dipati Narayan, in Chaturbhuj form. And others, like very small Paramatma Sakshi. Tini antarrahit atma. And jiv tadatmak. Antarrahit akhanda tattva. Jeev is not like that. Paramatma or Krishna? Paramatma. Jeev is Atma. And he is Param. Among all Jeev. Chetana Chetananam. Nityo Nityanam. Nityo Jivas. Nityanam. He is Supreme. And Nityo Nityanam. Chetanas Chetanam. Oh. So there are nine things Jeev is separate from Brahma. But separate. But don't think like that, that he is separate. Separate, no existence. Anyhow, he will be subordinate. In Golok Vrindavan also, here also. A kirtan kar do to. Oh, he will do. He will do kirtan. Give him. Oh. Stand up.
Each body, only one jiva.
Each body, prominent one, but one jiva. But in blood, one drop of blood, and millions of jivas are there.
Gurudev, does the jiva have precognition of what choice he's making when he's turning away from Krishna and looking at Maya and becoming enamored by Maya?
But I could not understand.
Jiva, at the moment when he decides to go to Maya or to Chit Shakti, does he know what he is doing?
No.
Nothing, no.
He's doing that, thinking that I'm doing best. I will enjoy this. Like a boy, he's going to catch a fire. He does not know. He thinks that anything to eat.
If the demons had practiced bhakti, they would have become purified. Why Krishna cheated them and put them into Mayavada?
What?
He's saying that because you explained that Shankaracharya, he came with the order from Krishna that the demons now they are practicing bhakti and they are trying to become like Hiranyakashipu. So he's saying, if they are practicing bhakti, then why they are not becoming purified from these material desires?
They want to be a demon like, with material power. That bhakti, doing bhakti. Dhruva Maharaj did bhakti. For what? For that kingdom. And if Ravan doing bhakti of Shankar, Brahma, for what thing? For power. And to
control the world.
Whole world and to give so much
trouble to others.
So bhakti is there, otherwise he cannot do anything. If bhakti is mishra, then you can have mukti or you can have swarga or anything. Otherwise, no. Have a kirtan. As you like? Jai Kunja Bihari or any? Have to jol though.
Jaya Rakshana Madhava Kunja
Jai 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 Jai
Once Vidur went to Himalaya Badrikashram near. There was Maitreya Rishi, very learned, and Krishna Kripa Patra. Krishna told Vidur later on that he used to go to Maitreya. And I have told everything to Uddhava or Maitreya. Maitreya will give you all knowledge. So Vidur went there and he asked Maitreya Rishi. It is very wonderful that Jeev is Chetan.
Conscious.
And always with Krishna, with Brahma, Parabrahma. But how? It became that Maya, Jiva was entangled in Maya. Then Maitreya is answering. Oh. I can tell you in brief only one reason. That Krishna power is aghatan ghatan patiyasi shakti. She can do?
Impossible to possible.
Possible. What is that?
She can make the possible impossible and impossible the impossible possible.
Possible.
What? Never impossible can make it.
So, aghatan ghatan pyas pateshi, Krishna has shakti. So, only this is reason. That he hides the mercy of Krishna. Paramatma, and she takes Jeev in condition. He becomes conditioned. So reason is what? That aghatan pyatishi. But this is the power of Krishna. She cannot do anything against the desire of Krishna. Then why Krishna doing so? That oh, so many jivas are suffering so much. Why? Tattu lila kaivalyam. Lila kaivalyam. There are so many pastimes of Krishna. Why not should this be?
Srishti lila.
Srishti lila. Krishna.
Why
Srishti lila? Oh, Srishti lila. This is Srishti lila. There should be no lacking. No. And there will be no question why. No. He's quite independent. You cannot ask any question. Why you have done so?
Why not?
Why not? Anything there you cannot. Oh, you cannot understand by yukti.
Argument.
Argument.
Logic.
You cannot. Achint bhav vishesh. Achintya khalu bhava na tans tarkena yojayet. Don't try to understand transcendental thing by your limited
intelligence.
You cannot. So what Vedas have told, especially what the essence of Vedas like Srimad Bhagavat has told, what our Goswami, essence of Bhagavat, they have told. We should rely on them. Bhagavat achinta shakti. By only this, Jeev comes my and mine in this body. And Maya ke prati moh. Moh? Bewildered by Maya. Only this reason. Vastuta.
Practically.
Practically or transcendentally. By constitutional form. Jivas are Shuddha.
Pure.
Because they have come from Shuddha Chit Shakti. But minute. But there is nothing Maya in his constitution. We say that now we are Baddha by cross and material body.
Soul body.
Now, Jeev, first Mahatattva comes, after that Ahankar, Ahankar then Man, Buddhi, Ahankar, Chit, all, and after that this
cross body
comes. This is Bandhan.
Bondage.
But this Bandhan is not true. You should not think that this is true. Maitreya Rishi is telling to Vidur. This Swarup Bhram. Swarup Bhram, you know, so many kinds of, but especially Dehatma Buddhi. This Swarup Bhram, if no light, no sun, darkness. What is darkness? Any satta of darkness?
Absence of light.
No
darkness does not exist.
No existence of
darkness.
Only where there is no sun, or there is night, there is andhakar. Oh, that is here. No Krishna service, oh Maya Bandhan. Like you are sleeping in the night and you are seeing a dream that my head is cut off. But when you will walk, then what you will see? Nothing. So when you will awoke, by the mercy of Guru, you said, oh, what I was seeing a dream like. So don't be nervous, upset in this Maya if suffering coming. See that this is due to sleepness. In this way, giving an example, Chandra is in sky.
Moon is in the sky.
Moon in the sky. And there is water. Any pond or anywhere. And Chandra, moon is?
Reflecting.
There is a tree there on the bank of that pond. But when air comes and there is kampan, shaking in pond, then it seems that tree is going at this end. Tree is there where it was. Moon is there. Moon is not
trembling.
But it seems. So Jeev is serving Krishna. But it seems that we are not serving. We are serving.
How is he serving?
Like you should give a cloth on watch.
Cover the watch.
We are seeing that no movement, nothing, but movement is going on. If you are Chit, Jeev Shakti, you are serving anyhow, in this bondage stage also. But you don't realize, you can think.
What service are we doing at the moment?
He is doing like Kansa in serving Krishna in direct way. If there was no Kansa, no sweet pastimes of Braja. If there was no Raman, no Ram Lila, no pastimes of Ram. You are also serving anyone, or any condition for, but he has no real relationship. But don't think that I'm serving. You are in dream, really. Narada is stolen. When he took darshan of, a glimpse darshan of Krishna, and at once it went down, went away, disappeared. Then he was weeping so much. Then an aerial sound came. Don't be nervous. Out of mercy, I have given a
Sporti
darshan.
Momentary vision.
To increase your
greed.
Now you cannot see me. If any slight, any gandh of, any smell of Maya in your heart, you cannot have my darshan. Now you should what do? Go everywhere. Take this Veena Yantra and speak my pastimes, you should
glorify
me. Narada Muni Bajaya Veena.
Radhika
Ramana Name. Everywhere he is going. So he is telling that, and Krishna told him, Ariel, that you should wait. How many years you will have to be here? And in the end you will have me. So he is telling, Prayujyamane mai tang suddhang bhagavati tanum arabdha karma nirvano napatat pancha bhautike. What meaning?
Microphone, please. Doesn't come here. What is this? Is this like a man made of it? Purnakala Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Srila Gurudev, what do you mean to speak? Briefly, upon this verse. Prayujyamane mai tam shuddham bhagavati
tanum. I'm finished.
Arabdha karma nirvano nyapatat pancha bhautika. This verse is spoken by Narada Rishi himself. He's explaining his own life experience to Srila Vyasadev, his disciple. He described how, after having the darshan of his Lord, he spent his life traveling here and there and doing kirtan. And then when the very last moment of his life came, just as lightning and illumination occur at the same time, so similarly, two things had happened at the same time. What? Prayujyamane mai tam shuddham bhagavatim tanum. At once he attained his transcendental body, which was suitable for rendering service directly to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And at the same time, prarabdha karma nirvano, his prarabdha karmas, any influence of maya was nyapatat pancha bhautika, it was completely removed. So, Srila Vishnathagiri Thakur, in his commentary on this verse, explained, it's just like Dhruva Maharaj. When Dhruva Maharaj was leaving this world to go to the Dhruvlok, as he went to step onto the airplane, suddenly he became effulgent. He became effulgent. He did not die, he did not give up his body. But there and then, the influence of Maya went away and he was situated in spiritual form. So in the same way, Narada Rishi, at that very last moment, just as lightning and illumination occur at the same time, similarly, the Nyapatat Pancha Bhautika, the influence of the material elements was withdrawn and he was situated in his eternal transcendental siddhadeha. This is a vastu siddhi, his perfection.
Thank you. So we have all a siddhadeha. Siddhadeha, you know? transcendental beautiful form in our body, all we have. And by that we can serve Krishna. Now it has been covered. By the mercy of Guru and Krishna, when time comes, all anarth goes away and we reach up to Rati stage, Bhav. Then Shuddha Sattva comes. And then you can realize your Siddha Deha. And that is called Swarup Siddhi. But here Narada's Vastu Siddhi. Vastu Siddhi. Not only Swarup Siddhi. He has received, realized Swarup Siddhi before. So we each have a very beautiful, marvelous,
attractive,
a body that is called Shuddha Deha, hidden here, but by the mercy of Krishna. Like Narada, at once this came and this cross body and mind, man, buddhi, ahankar, chitta, all
eliminated.
This is general, general niyam, rule. And what he told about Dhruva? Oh, not on all cases.
Exceptional case.
But there you must know, anyhow, he has left his that gross body and all. But anyone could not
see.
But regarding Krishna, you should not think like that. A dead body was there. And all the smart brahmanas, this sanskar of that body, willing this is cheating, nothing else.
Like a magic.
So, you should try to have mercy of Gurudev. And through him, you should try to do bhajan. Especially like Narada. Shunan subhadrani rathanga pani janmani karmani chajani loke
gitani namani tadarthakani gayan vilajjet
vicharir evang vratasva priya namakritya jatanurago jita chitta uchchai harsattatho rodati rauti gayat unmadyati nityati lokabhai. No shame at all. No shame. Loudly. Whether he is naked or what, not knowing, and always, sometimes laughing. Oh,
remembering
the pastimes of Krishna. Sometimes weeping. Oh, Krishna, where went?
Sometimes rolling on the ground.
And sometimes rolling on the ground. Sometimes, oh, ho ho, began to
laugh
loudly. All will think that he is mad. But not mad. This is the aim and object. You should try also. Always try to engage your mind in Shraman, Kirtan, Smaran, Pad, Sevan, Archan, Bandhan, Dasyam, Sak, especially Nam Sankirtan. Always engage. Then Maya cannot attack you. Otherwise, Maya will attract. Gaur, Premanande.
Hare Krishna. Hare Rama. Please be prepared for drama.
feather and the garland of forest flowers around your neck. Trick you.